Hello and a warm welcome to all of you amazing and beautiful people out there to my channel, The Twin Flame Union. In this channeling session, the message is for any and all divine feminines who have surrendered, who have done complete surrender, by the way. It is not the 50% surrender, 20% surrender, 70% surrender, 80% surrender, 90%, 99.9%, no. It's 100% surrender. Those divine feminines who have managed to go deeper into themselves and without even bothering about the proof given by universe or being given by God, completely surrendered and become the person of faith. This channeling is for them. What has been seen and observed that most women who are in this journey, most divine feminines, divine feminine energy, they are looking always for proof, some kind of proof. Oh, if this will happen in my life, only then I will believe in twin flame journey. If this will happen in my life, this will happen to me, then only I will believe that there is God. Then only I will believe in divinity. They don't want to let go. They don't want to let go at all. A lot of divine feminines who are on this journey are constantly complaining, cribbing, getting angry. They hate the separation, but they don't understand that whatever you resist will persist. Whatever you will hate or dislike, that thing will follow you. Whatever you will run after, that thing will never come to you. So the intelligent divine feminines are those who, instead of complaining, cribbing, blaming, abusing, cursing other channelers, cursing healers, cursing all the people who gave her this life, cursing any reasons that gave her this life, were very angry. And this anger is not just a phase, because anger is very much important. If you don't have anger, then how will you change? How will you work on yourself? But when this anger becomes second nature, when this anger, this cribbing, blaming becomes a part of who they are, then it is destructive. It is not going to help them anywhere, anywhere. This channeling is intended. So those who are complaining, cribbing, angry, blaming, they can continue to do that. This is what I've been told to say. They can continue to do that. That will affect only them. But it's a congratulatory message for, I can channel one divine feminine actually, but I know that this one divine feminine is actually representing a lot on planet Earth right now, a lot many. Anybody who's on the similar frequency, she has decided that she will not let her faith go on the divine journey, on the divine existence. And now she no longer needs proof or faith or grand finale is not needed for her anymore. The grand finale of this journey has already happened for her. And if you have seen my vlog, my video on final stages of Twin Flame Union, this channeling is on the lines of that, but that is an information video and this is a very strong channeling message that I have received, because I also had this question. Today only I had posted something about Krishna and Radha, and immediately I got a reply from someone saying that, oh, this is wishful thinking. Nobody wants to be in separation. Who wants separation? We don't want separation, but we still have it. We are still in separation. So don't let the quotes fool you. This is the language. Now, this language or these talks, which is intended towards the channeler or anyone who's giving the information, it doesn't really affect them in a long run. It can only be a momentary thing. And this momentary thing, then I asked this question to the universe. Immediately my guides answered. And they said that anyone who's cribbing, blaming, complaining, do not fall into this category. They are very far from ascension journey at least right now. Because what they have received, the separation is their own creation. This is not the separation which is out of the mission. Because when you're in the mission work, you can be in separation for 2 days, 3 days, 1 month, 9 months, 10 months, because you have to do certain work, you're on certain mission. You could be in the same, under the same roof, but you're so busy with your mission work, you're so busy with your research work, with your inner work, that you may not even, you know, talk to your divine masculine. Or like these things, you know, these are the things that sometimes make me very like shocked. Because I feel that who are these people, you know, who are these people? Who are these people? They are just creating a lengthy procedure for their own self because they cannot surrender. They always want a proof. They always want a proof. They want to see the union. And these are the people who see the union also, but the union never comes to them. And the union keeps coming and going. And I have said this before also. Before also I have said this, guys, I have said this so many times. Sometimes I also get very disappointed. But of course, this disappointment is not for those who have received a congratulatory message from the universe. Let me not get deviated because of some people who are always there to spread negativity. They don't understand that this negativity has engulfed their whole life and their own happiness and their own contentment is gone because of this. So this divine feminine, very strong, very powerful, very beautiful, full of inner beauty, she says that now I will practice my devotion every day, because she has actually come to that point. She has touched the point where she has understood that everything else is an illusion. Everything else is just a phase. It comes and it goes. But there is one thing that has been constant in this journey, is the connection she has with an invisible entity, invisible, supreme, very pure being, that she has figured out, this particular divine feminine and anyone who is on her frequency. Now she is like, my whole existence, she has faith on that. She doesn't want to question anymore. She's tired of questioning. She is done questioning. She's like, oh my God. You know, she got this headache. This divine feminine had migraine issues. She used to get a headache. But because of faith, because of devotion practice, because of surrendering, because of letting go, because of inner work, that chronic pain of hers is gone. That is one big sign for her that just because I released my negativity, my anger, my frustrations, and I let go, I have started becoming better and feeling better. So now you might think that this could be a proof for her. No, this actually followed her letting go, because this is how the universal laws work. There are certain universal laws, and if you follow the universal laws, everything will happen as per what the law has mentioned. Most of the people are against the universal law, so therefore they are suffering so much. Now, she has realized that something that was taking away her energy, taking away all her peace of mind. Now, for some people, it could be the divine masculine, because it's not like you reach the divine masculine right on day one. You obviously go to many stations, to many places, to many bus stops or to many airports where you meet different people. You have to kiss many frogs before you find your prince charming. So she has realized that this suffering or this it can be anything, like I said. It can be, what I'm receiving is that it can be a very harassing, a very painful family template. Some people that she was continuously looking at for love, for some comfort, for some support, she has not found it. She's done. She's reached the end point. And that end point has initiated this faith in her. It has lightened up her faith. Because, you know, it's like the story of Buddha had one assistant who was actually her brother. His name was Ananda. Now, Anand was always with Buddha, and he also had a special gift that whatever Buddha used to say anywhere, he used to remember it word by word, then he used to come back and he used to write it down or tell it to others. So, he was the one who spent maximum time with Buddha, but after Buddha's death, he was given 6 months to become an enlightened being, because people thought that he has been with Buddha for so long, so obviously he would be the one who would, you know, in one day he would become enlightened one, or one day he would get that post. It is this stage which is called Arhant. Arhant is right below Buddha, which means there are four stages. There is Sotapan, there is Sagdagami and Anagami, and then there is Arhant. Arhant is equal to Buddha, but it is said that when you become Arhant, you've basically solve this life and all your karma, and you will not be reborn again. You will be out of the cycle of birth and death forever. It's done. That work is done. Now, since most of you don't understand or probably don't know that this journey is actually, the goal of this journey is to free you from the cycle of life and death, so that you're not born again in this pattern, this earthly pattern. You're not born again, you're not reborn like that. So that's why in this current life itself, as I had mentioned in the 6-part series, I think that was in the 6th part or the 5th part, but it is mentioned that when you are out of this trap, out of this cycle, that's when you actually get freedom, and that's when your true ascension starts. That true ascension is impossible without surrendering. So this process of ending with all of these people in the family, the relationships, the bad relationships, the templates. So this divine feminine had spent, say, you could be one of them, 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, 60 years. In one loop, it is the biggest, most hardest, most difficult loop of her life. It was that loop that she was stuck in. So when I say 30 years, 40 years, 20 years, 25 years, so it is this difficult loop of her life, the most difficult loop of her life that she has worked out finally. This loop had taken all her energy, all her happiness, all her positivity. And she also knows that the reason why she has not been in union with Divine Masculine or with anybody, that she never found that love and that respect and that comfort and that loyalty, that presence, it was only because of this one loop. And for some of you, the reason I've been given these many numbers is because I can sense the energy of all those people, and that's why in between the channeling, I actually had to pause the channeling in between. I had to stop doing it because I was getting so angry. I was getting those angry vibes, to be very honest. And it's not that it is something wrong, I'm judging them. I'm not judging these divine feminines, because they're genuinely, they suffered. And despite being such pure souls, you know, they were born with the upper chakras were unblocked, open third eye, open crown chakra, open throat chakra, open heart chakra. And with all of those gifts, they were born, you know, even at that time, obviously during the birth, they were completely free. But one by one by one by one, the torture, the trauma, the suffering, the pain, it caused them to suffer so much. So their journey actually began right from the time they were born on planet Earth. So I am not just counting the twin flame journey for them. That's why I said congratulatory message from the universe. Obviously, the universe won't give such congratulatory message just like that. Now, that's why this particular channeling is so important and so special. And I really want to thank the universe for actually making me a medium for this channeling. So all of those divine feminines who have given the whole life, practically the whole life, because of one hard, difficult loop. And that one loop was actually connected to everything. literally everything. And this is what they figured out via inner work. They figured out that they did everything. They healed everything. They healed the karmic baggages. They healed the, areas of the inner child. They healed the finances. They healed confidence level. They healed the sacral chakra. But still they were getting stuck. But still they were being pulled down. But still they were feeling like there is a very heavy curse on them, a very heavy ancestral curse on them. Some of them even did ancestral healing. So they got connected to those ancestors who were the protective ancestors, and those protective ancestors became very strong because now they're all united. So it's almost like she is not alone. She has an army of God knows how many thousands of ancestors, all healed behind her. So this is the magic of separation. Those of you who are cribbing about separation, and their separation will, I don't know how long will it go on, because the separation is in the mind. They are not able to heal the separation. They are not able to heal the complaining and cribbing and blaming. Once you go beyond the complaining, cribbing, and all of those negative feelings, blaming especially, then only you can have the need of doing inner work. Then only you would spend as much time as you want for the inner work. And if the dark nights come, if the lower moments come, if the negative feelings come, then you would want to heal it in a right way, not heal it in the typical way that we see in many divine feminines as well. Not these ones, obviously the other ones. So these divine feminines, the ones who are getting the congratulatory message, these ones especially, they have actually done a lot of work, because they knew about this before they were being sent to Earth, or before they were coming to Earth voluntarily. They knew that these difficulties will come. And in their template, they did not have these difficulties. They chose this template. They chose to heal a template way back, because whenever a divine feminine or a divine masculine heals their own area, their own inner work, they heal the template way back to the ancestors. So it's a very special work. It's a very big work that you're here for. And all of those people who underestimate this journey, underestimate all the things that you're here to do, underestimate the fact that you're here for a reason, your existence has a role to play, those people, I don't want to say anything to them anymore. Because in my channelings, I have realized that I'm actually more connected towards the people who are on the inner work and advanced soulmate journey, or they are still in the runner chaser, but they're open to work on themselves. They're open to be more accepting and understanding. They are not the cribbing ones. They're not the cribbers, the blamers, the negative nuisance creators. They're not the one. It's not that divine feminines don't do that. There is a stage. Of course, there is a stage. But the intelligent ones would understand that stage, being in that stage, is futile. It's futile. It's totally futile. It's pointless. And trust me, I know this by my own experience as well. Because you have to think that one relationship does not work, second does not work, third does not work, fourth does not work. No relationship works, be it karmic, be it DM, be it soulmate. If nothing is working, then definitely you have to do some work. You cannot just sit and blame the world. So this is the time to take responsibility. Anyway, so what has happened now is that particular loop, it was like such a bad loop that it was sucking all the blood, sucking all the energy, sucking all the goodness. And, she was going on doing work. Like, she would do something, she would start a business, it would not work. She would start a new project, it would not work. She would say start a new relationship, it would not work. She would do anything she would do, it will not work. It was related to this energy sucking loop of people, you can say, who were connected with her, attached with her. So finally, after all these years, I feel this actually, she has finally learned the truth, that she will be on her faith and she will be in this divine journey now without any questions. There is a very strong energy source that is being run in her now, because the heart chakra is fully healed right now. And the fire, you know, the fire or the energy that goes from the Kundalini, from the Mooladhara to the Sushumna, it's like it's creating this gush of energy. Now she doesn't care. It's like she can't be good to people who she doesn't like. She can't be a people pleaser. She can't say anything sweet or nice. She's not even interested. She's not interested in the worldly talk. She's just not into it. She's just not into it. She's like, oh, I don't care. It's like, you know, the state that Meera found when she was completely dancing on the streets, singing songs for Krishna. The state that Parvati had found when she knew that Shiva is the one for her, and she was so happy doing the inner work because she had to remove the curses. It was her responsibility. The Divine Feminine is now very happy to take the responsibility. She is so happy to, you know, do this. She is not like no longer cribbing. She's not. Everything is looking to her like a miracle, like, you know, she has solved the puzzle. Though there is still more to solve, but she has solved this puzzle and now she's like, I can focus. This is also happening because the energy that was earlier getting totally wasted. It's like the effort, all of the work that she was doing, also because she did not know. She didn't know that all of this work that I'm doing, or something nice she would be doing, something happy she would be doing, she did not know where is the energy going. So now she is like caught on to that energy. She knows who are the people, because of whom, what is the reason, why is she facing this. She has figured it out. She has caught it up. She's caught on to it, and she's caught on to it very brilliantly. It was like a research for her. All of these years of research. Where is this coming from? Where is this coming from? Why is this not happening? So all the failures she faced, she did not get disheartened by those failures. So the people who were sucking in her energy, they actually thought that now she is gone into the dust. She cannot rise up. She cannot stand up. She just cannot do that. And then when they found out that she cannot rise up, she cannot do anything, she's just a dead meat, you know, she has no more energy. Or, you know, for some people, this age factor was also there. For some divine feminines, other factors were there because of which they were being told that, you know, now your time is over. It's gone. It's nothing can happen. So then they started showing up their real side to her, which is the side full of, you know, like humiliation, humiliating her, nagging her, saying very mean things to her, things that can actually make a person die. The words were so mean. They were so negative. It was like, you know, you look at someone with disgust in your eyes and in your energy, that type of thing. So earlier what was happening was those people and those situations, it was under a mask. A mask is being shown to me in this channeling continuously. It's like the mask, people are wearing masks also these days. So what she experienced is those people were wearing a mask. The mask of goodness, the mask of being a well-wisher, the mask of being her friends and, you know, those who are there for her, those who stand for her, stand by her. So what happened was that all these years of inner work and constantly cutting away from materialism, cutting away from greed, cutting away from all of these things, so all of those materialistic people who were otherwise not her well-wishers, but they were wearing a mask of the well-wisher, they were the ones who were sucking all the energy. Because whenever she would start a business, start a new job, start a good work, or start a new relationship, these people were always casting negative energy on her, that she will fail, she's a failure, she's a loser, she's a nothing, she's good for nothing, she's just too stupid, or she's over smart, or she's overconfident, and she doesn't deserve to be happy. Always having disbelief, always negating everything. So if she would say, let's do this, they would say, no, 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 that's not a good idea. But earlier they were doing it with the mask. The mask was still on. Because while wearing the mask, you can say many things. You can, you know, use love as a bait. You can or use some kind of logic. So they would deviate her from the path. Though she was, her real path was the inner work, which obviously not many people know, because inner work is the area of silence. You don't tell people where I have reached or what I'm experiencing or what is my stage now, what is my connection. You don't talk that. That's when your inner work actually becomes inner work. If you're going on blabbering about the inner work, you're going on talking about it, you're competing with people, you're showing off your knowledge, then obviously it's not inner work. So with these people who were actually energy vampires, they did not know what level of her inner work she has reached. So now is the point where she made them believe that she's over. It's done. She cannot go anywhere beyond this. You know, it's like her last point has come. It's dead for her. Or she gave her final try, and now after the final try, everything is dead end. So that's the time when they all, you know, removed the mask and they showed the real faces. These real faces, which are being ruled by evil entities, they are the slaves of evil entities. They are being controlled very easily by evil entities. So they are the ones, they show the real face to the divine feminine. And when she sees the real faces of these people, now she finally knows, oh, so this is where my energy was going. Earlier, I did not know, because there was a curtain, there was a veil, there was a mask. So I did not really know. I was just going on, you know, like hoping that there is some good energy coming from somewhere. But now when you know, then your expectations are over, and then you realize that, okay, so I'm never going to give even 1%, 1.1% of my energy to this. I will never do it. So she has closed that doorway from where, and it's like a permanent closure. This, with this permanent closure will come her permanent rebirth. The permanent rebirth of the divine feminine will lead to the permanent rebirth. I said debirth, actually. The permanent, it's actually sort of debirth, because the old identity will completely die and the new identity will rise up. And with her rebirth, the divine masculine will also see a rebirth. So the divine masculine is now getting reborn. But this is the stage right after surrender, which means she has picked on to faith. So I'm not saying, I'm not in this channeling talking about anything else. Rather, I'm saying that the biggest chunk of the energy vampires is now being discovered by her after years. In fact, her whole life on planet Earth was actually meant for this point, this purpose, this reality, this place in this journey. So this is exactly what is being reflected by the divine masculine, who will definitely feel the fire, who will feel this energy from coming from her, and he will be automatically completely drawn towards her from now onwards, from this point onwards. Yes, even if they are not communicative, even if they don't talk, there is a silence between them, but still he has energetically made that shift, and that is most important. And for all of those people who want to look for proofs, who are looking for constantly doing the same thing, please, these channelings are not meant for you. So please do not come here. Please do not spread your negativity. Please do not, it's okay to give your thoughts and your pain. Many people discuss it and I read that. But the moment you start condescending the universal domain, you start condescending the higher energies, you start condescending gods like Krishna and Radha, Ram and Sita, then that is where I really feel like, you know, blocking such people. And I actually have done that. You can condescend the channeler also, because I'm just a servant of the divine. I have no really such purpose. But when you start talking about, you know, your comparisons with gods and goddesses and with what they have suffered, you don't even want to realize, because you're so blind. You're so blind from blame games. You're so blind, such people. And I have to include them in this journey, because I think I have to, and I'm being divinely guided to do so. You don't understand that the pain Shiva and Shakti went through. You don't understand the pain that Ram and Sita went through. You don't understand the pain that Radha and Krishna went through. But they smiled throughout that pain. And even while they lived on that plane, they smiled throughout the whole journey. They smiled for others. They smiled for their missions. And they were born in such a time. Lord Sri Ram and Sita were born in descending त्रेता युग एंड राधा एंड कृष्णा वर बॉर्न इन डिसेंडिंग द्वापर. दिस हैज अ लॉट ऑफ इफेक्ट बिकॉज द एनर्जीज आर डिसेंडिंग एंड वी आर इन द असेंडिंग द्वापर. वी आर गोइंग टूवर्ड्स असेंशन. सो वी शुड बी वेरी थैंकफुल बिकॉज वी आर नॉट फेसिंग वॉट दे फेस. बट दे नेवर कंप्लेन. दे नेवर एवर कंप्लेन. दे डिडंट इवन कंप्लेन अबाउट द डीएम. दे जस्ट स्माइल थ्रू आउट द इनर वर्क, इनर जर्नी. दे स्माइल थ्रू आउट दिस टाइम एंड दे सेड टू वन सेल्फ, वन अनदर, एंड दे ऑलवेज थैंक गॉड to give them that particular life where at least they know what faith is. Faith is not a scientific algorithm or a scientific equation that can be solved. And all of those people who are looking for God in science, I must tell them that God cannot be found through formulas. God can only be found through faith. You have faith. In Hindi, it's called Vishwas. You have faith. Only then you can do these things. This is the journey of love. You cannot be so conditional, so greedy in love. You have to be unconditional. But unconditional does not mean being a vegetable. That's anyone can come and cut you. You have to take care of yourself and you have to heal your wounds and your inner child. You have to heal the divine father, divine mother. When they are all healed, when the whole family is healed, that's when the rainbow bridge will open and that's when the unconscious and the conscious reality will be connected and a new reality, a singular reality will be created. Now for all of these divine feminines who are on this journey, who are the ones receiving the congratulations from the universe is also telling you that the secrets, the magic, the miracles, the love of the divine, it will all be given to you. And this is actually reminding me of my time when I was in Pokhara. This was when I was meditating for about 2 to 3 months without fail. I was very disciplined at that time and very regular. And this was my phase of receiving these mystical visions from the universe where I saw the connection between the rivers, the mountains, the trees, the beings, the clouds, the sky, everything was connected to each other in the form of sacred geometry. I had never had such visions. Back then I had those visions. And just after this experience and this phase is when my father fell sick and he passed over to another realm. So I kind of figured out that that was my completion of a certain template which was related to patriarchy, which got healed at that time. And his job also was done. I did connect to my father after he passed over. So what I will tell to you all is keep moving on. You're doing fine. This is a really good sign. And the universe is saying that you will get complete support from all of the resources, from the sun and the moon and the rivers and the earth and the mountains. And because you see, the thing is, when your third eye is basically the connection to the cosmic world. When your third eye is completely open and unblocked and it's working, it's getting the energy, it means that it's connected to every other being of this planet, of this cosmic world. So everyone will become one with you, and your heart chakra, this will open up, expand your heart chakra, and you will be so present, so agile, so aware. And I'm not saying this for anyone who thinks that this means you will be dancing like a peacock every day in the rain. No, it means that you will be more stable, more connected, more powerful, more mission oriented. You will become a beautiful soul. You are a beautiful soul, of course, but this beauty, this inner beauty will now be reflected outside because the source is with you now, and you are the one who actually decided to go with the source. So you are the one who has done it. So good job. Take your hand with your own hand, tap your back, pat your back. You've done a brilliant job, and keep it up.